Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to our annual Thanksgiving and valedictory service, honoring the class of 2021 held virtually this year. We praise God for his faithfulness to us, especially during the past academic year. It is only by his grace that we have been able to complete this year so successfully. We are grateful to you, class of 2021. You have already inspired us. You have risen with determination to push through some of the enormous and unexpected challenges of this global pandemic. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin the processional. Over to Mrs. Deepa George, the ISC coordinator.
Thank you, Mrs. Ausef. The procession is led by school captain and house captain Aaron Manocharan of Barton House. School vice captain and house vice captain Sarah Jacob Chavra of Wilcox House. Graduating class of 2021, Barton House. House vice captains Gilbert Peewee and Vidita Hilda Govindachari. Senior prefects Bridget Unni, Sparsha Dayanand, and Samuel Joshua Peter. Prefects Meher Arshad, Shania Stanley, Nihal Vargis John, and Rohit Suju, followed by members of the house, Leah C, Nikhila Devapatla, Pavitra GK, Prachi Bharatiya, Pradikya Vinktesh, Rida Tahreen, Afshan Sharif, Amy Elizabeth Thomas, Audriana John, Cynthia Patrick, Gloria Sharon D'Souza, Rebecca Belicia Wardy A, Shaina Christina Ignatius, Christina Sarah, Kushi R. Vaswani, Prerna T, Sanvi S, Carol Miriam Joby, Irene Joanna Phillips, Jane Samuel, Meenakshi Vijay Shinde, Renu Karen S, Rhea Esther Washington, Dania Teresa Shaji, Jennifer Elizabeth Shaji, Kashish Chaudhya, Roshni Ramalingam, Tejaswi Maha S, Catherine Anto, Natalie Zeta Myers, Aaron D. Jeshurun, Abdul Basit, Adarsh Shankar, Benny Paul, Irfan Tahir, Joel Matthew Joseph, Joshua Jordan Augustine, Ryan Farhan, Shamik M, Vishal Abraham Thomas, Mukesh Varma M, Roshan Kumar D, Suhas Purushottam N, Theophilus Manan Stephen, Adrian P. Joseph, Joel Brownie George, Nathan Koshi Chandi, Satyanarayana Gowda D, Sulaiman Abdullah Sharif, Yashwin Esmi, Adnan Imran Seth, Josh Jiju Thomas, Joshua P.K. Kurian, Mohammed Sharik Sharif, Romaldo Anthony, Jaden Brownie George, Joshua Thomas Philip, Kenneth Roy, Mahir Ahmed, Rohan Raj Kolanjeri, Naif Ahmed, Noah Khan, Saeed Ayman, and Elijah C. John. Over to our ICSC coordinator, Mrs. Mary George. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Deepa George. Presenting to you the graduates of Redwood House, led by House Captain Jenica Thomas. House Vice Captains Syed Mohammed Ali and Janet R. George. Senior Prefects Shweta Vinod, Joseph Paul Arnold, and Mohammed Fuad Seth. Prefix Kushi L. Gandhi, Anaga Madan, Jonathan Yimson, and Puneet G. Members of Redwood House are Anju Raghavi R, Brian Krizan Pereira, Kristen Nakulu Luro, Matania Wilfred, Sherlyn J, Amrita Raghupati, Dania Altaf, Irin Mazamil, Jemima M, Shiva Ria Ritchie, Tejaswini LR, Arashi Chakraborty, Gabriela Wilman, Ritika R, Saida Zwana Fatima, Trisha Magesh, Aditi S. Nair, Ashra Pratiti Bhaskaran, Hannah Carolyn Samuel, Joanne Roji George, Sophia Corson, Sarah Miriam Thomas, Chikaina Yim Sun, Cheryl Elizabeth Thomas, Neha Manilal P, Kezia Samantha Stephen, Melanie Magdalene DeCosta, Raksha Naidu, Esther Jessica David, Neha A. Justin, Nishta Sgambato, Sarah Benjamin, Josiah Vijay, Ritin John Sajit, Sukrit Thomas A, Joash Matthew, Mervin Ezekiel V. Panikulam, Mervin Joseph DeCosta, Pranav Raj H.N., Rowan Hassan N., Syed Atif Altaf, Syed Oways I., Jason Andrew D., Kaushik J., Shivashankar N. Nagaraj, Jovan Francis N., Samuel P. Chine, Talha S. Asif, Anish Daniel P.J., Syed Omar Ahmed, Usman Zet, Akshay Regwin Joseph, Ivan A. Justin, Gregory Samuel, Mohammed Gibran, Dylan Babu, and Shimon Matthew Thomas. Congratulations, dear children. God bless you. Ad Astra. Handing over to Mr. E.J. Joyson, NIOS and CIC coordinator. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. George. We now move on to the graduating class of 2021 from the Theobald House. The house captain, Sarah Elizabeth George. House vice captains, Ashish Daniel L. and Rebecca Ann Daniel. Senior prefects, A. Alfred Rubin, Jeffrey Jeeva Das, and Karen Rena C. Prefects, Joanna Rachaprodo, Sneha V, Joel Vergis Simon, and Richard Mark Augustine. The members of the Theobald House are as follows: Megha Atayat, Preeta A, Sarah Jane Robin, Sri Namruta R, Alina Ruth Josiah, Anna Ann Kurian, Anna Paul, Daniela Netanya Gia Ribello, Tamara Daniel, Abigail Sarah Thomas, Anna Lucin Alicia, Lirisha S, Shireen Wilson, Sonakshi PB, Tia Ann Richard, Beryl Abby Thomas, Jubel Nitin William, Joyce A, Nancy J. Joyce, Sean Abira Devraj, Vaishnavi M, A. Vaishnava Lakshmi A, Anne Rachel Jiju, Hannah Mahin, Nikita Thomas, Sahana N, Teresina Shantipriya Gigoy, Rabia Basri, Simra Hashim, Renee Nakshatra Allen, TJ Monisha, Aditya Ranveer Reno, Ashwin Philip, David Sean Cyrus, Rohit S, Yashas S, Darshan S, George Matthew, Javin Bruce Serlo, Stephen Jacob Cherian, Anas Sharif, Ashirwad Zion Samuel, Jaden Samuel Jacob, Shashwat V.S., Saurish P.V., Shreyas Shankar, Sai Madhav L., Jordan Abraham Titus, Mark Kenneth Gray, Muhammad Usman, Siddhant Jain, Prabhav Shastri, and Prarthan R. Shetty. Moving on to the Wilcox House, the house captain, Saad, house vice captain, Mika Joseph, senior prefix, Melissa Elizabeth Fernandez, Tejas Vinnie G, and Ethan Murlidharan. Prefix, Melvisha Shanil Manuel, Natanya Rebecca Karinyapalli, Nathan Thomas Zachariah, and Aditya V. Prakash. The members of the Wilcox House are as follows: Karen Nitika A, Mrudula R, Niharika Kanwar, Prerna Pishe, Vaishnavi K, Annie Abigail George, Asfa Amjad, Karen Natanya Anil, Kiara Chantal Arland, Prakruti P. Shetty, Rachel Burgess, Divya Darshini M, Mukta Sagar Shirguppi, Ranya P, Ria Abigail D, Samyukta R, Anagha Ashwin Mayampuratta, Harini Prakash, Anika Janice Rajkumar, Erika Grace Manu, Nina Blazy, Reshmi R, Samiksha P, Arva A. Nagaria, Irene Christine Jain, Hemant S, Johan Koshi, Joshua Sam Chiramal, Sumant C, Jaden Gerard Carroll, Jonathan Samuel Smith, Kenneth R, Muhammad Abdullah Khan, Muhammad Arsh Rizwan, Shavin Aaron Savai, Abraham S, Arjun A.G., Isaiah Matthews Panika, Leander Savio Pope, Lionel Savio Gabriel, Kapilesh Narayan P, Nikhil S. Joseph, R. Srivatsa, Sarvana Kumar D.C., Sean Joshua P, Sujay Vikram G.S., Muhammad Faisal Ahmed, R. Ricky Zachariah, Dishant Sebamale Napoleon, Muhammad Akib, Muhammad Hamza, Krishna Leena Vijay Sasi, and Roshan Daniel Ravindra. Ladies and gentlemen, those are our students of the graduating class of 2021 from the four different houses. I now hand it over to Mrs. Sunita Ausif, the junior school coordinator, to preside over the remaining part of the program. Thank you.
Thank you, coordinators and students. Shall we all join in singing the hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness? I invite Mr. Sujit Thomas Zachariah and father of Nathan Thomas Zachariah, class 10B, to lead us in prayer.
Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you for another year that you have guided Clarence High School faithfully. Even in the midst of these challenging times, God, you have graciously provided for its every need. We thank you for sustaining the school and blessing all its efforts. We thank you, Lord, for your forbearance in times of failure and for your wisdom for all the decisions that have been taken for the good of the school. Lord, as we look back, we thank you for the vision of the founders of the school and for their labor in establishing it for your purpose. We thank you for the management who by your grace plan and watch for the good of the school, and for the trustees for their constant prayer support. In gratitude, we uphold our principal and the teaching and non-teaching staff of the school who have given their best, and we pray for your continued guidance, empowerment, and encouragement for all of them. We are also grateful for the interest and help of many friends from across the world. Lord, we commit these graduating students into your hands. We thank you for your goodness in their lives thus far and for their hard work. As they step out into the world, please help them to grow in the fear of the Lord, and we pray for your protection and blessing on them. We commit today's service and everything that is to be said and done in your presence. May it all be for the glory of your name. All this we ask in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, Mr. Zachariah. On behalf of the principal, staff, and students, it is my privilege to welcome each of you to our annual Thanksgiving and Valedictory Service 2021. I extend a very warm welcome to our honorable guest speaker, Mr. Wilfred Davidar. I also welcome the trustees of the Clarence Educational Trust and chairman and members of the Board of Management, Clarence High School. A warm welcome to our parents and friends and to our graduating class of 2021. We deeply appreciate your presence with us this morning. The school captain, Erin Manocharian of Class 12 Science, leads the student body of the school. It's our pleasure this morning to listen to him as he addresses the August gathering. Erin Manocharian.
Good morning. The journey of 1,000 miles starts with a single step. 13 years ago, most of us took that one little step when we stepped into the corridors of this prestigious institution. Our parents had a worried look. Some of us were scared, some of us on the brink of shedding tears, and a few of us uncertain of our emotions. Since then, the steps of many miles have brought us to this day of culmination, confident, diligent, and ready to take on what life has to offer. And at this crossroads, we resonate the words, "Every day is a blessing from God. Let go of what was and have faith in what's to come." respected Chief Guest Mr. Wilfred Davidar, members of the Clarence Educational Trust, members of the Board of Management Clarence High School, Principal Dr. Jerry George Matthew, Vice Principal Mrs. Ruth Manoj, coordinators, staff, alumni, parents, and my fellow Clarencians. Greetings of the day to one and all watching this online. It is indeed an honor and a privilege to address on this auspicious occasion on behalf of the graduating class of 2021. At the outset, we thank God Almighty for showering us with His grace and mercy and for His faithfulness in sustaining each and every one of us throughout this journey. Today, as we stand at this threshold, let us hold close the words written in Joshua chapter 1 and verse 9. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and of good courage. Do not be afraid nor be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. In the words of Fred Rogers, so many people have helped me to come to this stage. Some of you are here, and some of you are far away. All of us have those special ones who have loved us into our being. At this time, let's take a moment to reflect upon and appreciate all those who have helped us on our journey thus far as a friend, philosopher, and guide. As each one of us would recount, this academic year has been singularly significant as the COVID-19 had tried to spread its tentacles on our curriculum. But thanks to the trustees and the Board of Management, visionaries as they are, no stone was left unturned in equipping us towards the holistic development as well as the knowledge uptake. Thank you, sirs and ma'am. To our wonderful principal, Dr. Jerry George Matthew, thank you for your leadership and guidance. You have been an epitome of inspiration and an amazing source of strength and support for all the students. Thank you, dear Vice Principal, coordinators and teachers, for all the wholehearted efforts you have put in all these years, and especially during these roller coaster pandemic times. Through your lives and your counsels, you have instilled in us the virtues of honesty, hard work, and integrity. Challenges are what make life interesting. Overcoming them is what makes them meaningful. Thank you for so unselfishly sharing your knowledge, time, and care with us. We acknowledge that all teachers went beyond the call of duty. In spite of unfavorable learning conditions, you have sacrificially put in your best efforts to ensure that we are well prepared to take on any challenges the future has in store for us. Dear teachers, you took pains in making us assimilate the topics with ease towards our academic excellence. You instilled the right values which we cherish. You also put in sincere efforts to make our classes more interesting and learnable, despite our blank screens and switched off cameras. You motivated us to perform at higher standards. Thank you, dear teachers. To our office and IT staff, thank you for all your sincere efforts in ensuring proper admin support at all times. To our field staff, thank you for all your hard work in keeping our school so hygienic and splendid. I would be failing in my duty if we didn't take a moment to appreciate our parents. Thank you for your unconditional love, care, and support. We have experienced your tenderness and goodness in manifold ways, which is a source of strength for us. A Japanese proverb says, "A father's goodness is higher than the mountains. A mother's goodness is deeper than the sea," which indicates that they are immeasurable. One of the most distinguishing features of this school has been the morning assembly, which is the first thing that takes place every morning. These sessions have taught me the importance of keeping God first before everything. Indeed, the Clarencian studentship has taught each one of us the truth, which I quote, "The secret of a meaningful life is giving God the first part of your day, the first priority to every decision, and the first place in your life." The school has endeavored to make every student strive for excellence by granting opportunities aplenty, keeping pace with the motto of Pat Riley, who said, "Excellence is the gradual result of always striving to do better." As the school captain, on behalf of the class of 2021, who wave their farewell hands, assuring our mentors that each one of us shall endeavor to translate our learning here into self-actualization and better citizenry. Dear class of 2021, congratulations. We have accomplished a notable milestone in our journey. But remember, a milestone doesn't show the distance we have already traveled. It always shows the distance that is to be traveled, yonder and beyond. We don't have all the glamour that is typically associated with this occasion, especially concerning the musical march, the elegant suits and saris, and a delicious valedictory dinner. But what we do have is the character we have been molded to by this institution. And no one and no situation, even this pandemic, can take that away from us. Retrospecting the many years spent in this microcosm of learning life, we, the class of 2021, can say that the years spent together shall be relished as years of fostering friendship and goodwill. True friends are never apart, maybe in distance, but never in heart. The road ahead may be strewn with unknown challenges, but we ought to remember to face them boldly. We must strive for excellence in everything we do, large or small. Yes, we are trained for sublime heights, and we will reach the pinnacle of our purpose by giving our utmost for the highest. Because when you succeed, you are in a position to give rather than take. Our lives will be purposeful when we give and serve others through our achievements. That's how we remain different, exuding the ethos of this institution. Friends, while we are geared to achieve success, and probably to leave a legacy thereof, remember, success is not measured in terms of money or popularity. It's to leave those with whom you cross paths a little more happiness and hope. As we step out, be sure that the God who has led us thus far will continue to lead us through the next phase of our lives. We are like caterpillars, but the days will dawn in that we shall become splendorous butterflies, adding charm to this earth. All that we have learned leads to this simple truth. Strive for excellence, help those who are in need, and give your utmost for the highest. Class of 2021, it's been a splendid 13 years with you. And from the bottom of my heart, I wish you all the very best. Dos Vidania, Danke schön, and thank you.
Thank you, Aaron. Satya Swarup Deva, a devotional dance by our students, celebrating God's omnipotence and his love, seeking his strength during struggles and his guidance to take the right path that leads to victory. Ladies and gentlemen, Light of Hope, presented by our students.
तीनों की सेवा में धर्म के राहों में जीवन ये खोकर मैं जीवन पाऊं। तीनों की सेवा में धर्म के राहों में जीवन ये खोकर मैं जीवन
Naveen Thomas, Director, Bangalore Baptist Hospital, and father of Nikita Thomas, Class 12, Humanities, to share his reflections.
More than a century ago, the Redwood brothers would never have known or imagined what their response to the prodding that they received in their hearts would result in. They obeyed, they started this initiative, and down the decades, so many Clarencian children would go on to become upstanding citizens of the country, contributing so much to nation building. And as a proud parent of Nikki, who's just finishing 12th standard, and of Amit, who went through Clarence High School 8 years ago, I want to say a big thank you for what you have sown into these children, into their hearts, into their value systems. I can think of three things. The first is that Clarence has taught the children that success is all about faithfulness. It's not just about accumulating wealth or status or anything else. It's about being faithful where one is placed. The second thing that Clarence has taught them is that happiness is about others, that it is about being relevant to others, of being of help to others, and that is very special. I also feel that what Clarence has taught them is that true fulfillment is in realizing one's potential that God has placed within them. I think for this we are grateful. Looking back, We have much to be grateful for. And looking at what's happening now, we are truly happy and we rejoice in the fact of the growth that Clarence has experienced. And looking ahead, we look forward with trust and hope, knowing that brighter days are yet to come, greater things are yet to be done. Thank you, Clarence.
Dr. Naveen Thomas, I now invite Mrs. Lori Shine, mother of Samuel Shine, Class 12 Science, to share her thoughts.
Good morning, respected Board of Management, Principal Dr. Jerry George Matthew, Vice Principal Mrs. Ruth Manoj, teachers, parents, and dear children. I count it an honor to speak on behalf of the parents of the graduating class and to represent some of our thoughts and reflections on the happy occasion of seeing our children graduate at the annual Thanksgiving and Valedictory Service 2021. My association with Clarence High School goes back to 13 years and has been a long, fruitful, and memorable one. Today, even as I speak, I go down memory lane where my children, Samuel P. Shine of Class 12 Science and subsequently Grace, entered Clarence High School as toddlers in prep. I have seen them grow into well-rounded human beings in all spheres, and I know the same holds good for all their classmates. Today, I stand here as a proud parent of a confident child, and the credit for this goes to Clarence High School as well as every parent here. On behalf of all the parents of the graduating class, I would like to express our gratitude to Clarence High School, both the administrative and academic faculties who have guided our children, encouraged them, and inspired them to give their very best in every possible way. What I admire the most is the values that the school has inculcated in the children. Just like the motto of the school says, our utmost for the highest, and the verse that reads, the reverence of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. I can confidently say these values have been deeply inculcated in the life of every student at Clarence. The school has inculcated in the children the value of fearing the Lord with a reverential fear, as well as respecting and revering their elders. The Clarencians that I have met are well-mannered and well-grounded, children who uphold great values. The children are all set to begin the next chapter in their lives, hoping for a bright future and also preparing to face a competitive world. I am sure that they will be able to face these challenges with boldness, self-belief, and moral values they have picked up in the morning assemblies over the years at Clarence High School. As parents, we are indeed thankful to all the teachers from prep to class 12 who have motivated, encouraged, and guided our children to be the youngsters they are today. You have invested in their lives, helping them in their struggles and being patient with them when they were naughty. I am sure that the children will carry fond memories with them, and they will time and again remember the values you have invested in them. At this time, I want to thank the school and congratulate it for the way it has handled the COVID-19 pandemic. In spite of the pandemic and its limitations with in-house schooling, Clarence High School was very quick in adapting with the online system of schooling. In fact, the online classes have made us parents part of the morning assemblies and the teaching. Today, I take this opportunity to thank the school for instilling the best of education, a confident and healthy outlook, and excellent moral values for a lifetime. Thank you for shaping the lives of our children to be responsible citizens of this nation. As our children are getting graduated, I wish them all the best for their board exams and for the future assignments that await them. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. God bless you. Have a blessed day.
Thank you, dear parents, for your heartfelt and touching reflections. We cherish your feedback and feel honored to have been a part of your lives. I hope you never lose your sense of wonder. I hope you never fear those mountains in the distance. Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. Over to our senior choir for the song, I Hope You Dance.
Let's go.
you, choir, for the rendition. It is my privilege to introduce our guest speaker, Mr. Wilfred Davidar. Mr. PWC Davidar, IAS, Additional Chief Secretary, retired, currently a public policy and business strategist. Mr. Davidar completed his degree in commerce and post-graduation in public administration in the Madras Christian College, Tambaram. Later, Mr. Davidar completed MA in Development Studies in the Institute of Social Studies, The Hague in Netherlands. Worked as assistant professor in political science in MCC for 5 years and entered the Indian Administrative Service in the year 1986. Some of the assignments Mr. Davidar held include Corporation Commissioner Madurai, Corporation Commissioner Chennai, Collector Vellore, Special Secretary, Health and Project Director, Tamil Nadu Health Systems Project, Principal Secretary, Information Technology, Principal Secretary, Energy, Principal Secretary, Personnel and Administrative Reforms, Member Secretary, Sports Development Authority of Tamil Nadu, Chairman and Managing Director of Tamil Nadu Urban Finance and Infrastructure Development Corporation, and retired as Additional Chief Secretary, Transport Department. Mr. Davidar also served 2 terms as the President, Tamil Nadu IAS Officers Association, and for 5 years as the President, Tamil Nadu State Amateur Boxing Association. He is also a policy expert for organ transplant initiatives in India. His other interests include athletics, games and karate in school, music, boxing, debating, and college union activities in college. He is married to Dr. Shanti Davidar, psychiatrist at Rainy and Kalyani Hospitals. The couple have 3 working sons, 2 of whom are married. Ladies and gentlemen, the valedictory address by Mr. Wilfred Davidar.
It gives me great pleasure to address you all on this Thanksgiving and valedictory service for the Clarence School, Bangalore. And it's really a privilege for me that I've been invited. I want to thank the principal and other management members of the management who have requested me. I always deem it a great privilege to be able to address a school audience or a college audience. It's such a blessing, and I'm really grateful for this opportunity. When many years later, when you have left the school and you've gone on in life, you will always go back and thank God for your school. You may have some good memories, you may have some bad memories, but nevertheless, we're all wired to our schools. I passed out of my school in the Madras Christian College School in 1975. And even now, so many years later, I still go back there and reminisce, the good things that happened, the difficult things that happened, things that you had to overcome. And it's always a pleasant feeling because you know how far you have come. And so I really want to say, even while you're still in the school and passing out in your 10th, and you may not be coming back, or in your 12th, or you may not be coming back, but just to look at the future and, say, hey, this is the place that I was a part of. This is the place that I actually studied in. And thank God for that. I'm going to take the privilege of giving you some 5 things that would maybe strike a chord in your heart as you prepare to move on. Some of you on the 12th moving on, and some of you in the 10th who may come back to your 11th, but still it is a very crucial point in your time. So let me just come on to these 5 points You know, I know we're all into giving advice. The older you get, the more you tend to, you know, want to try to pitch in and say something concrete or helpful. And I'm hoping that this will actually be helpful. You know, the five things are this. The first thing is simply this. Recognize that you don't control everything. Recognize that you don't control everything. In fact, the one who controls everything is God. When you are younger, when I was younger, I felt I had a lot of things under my control. But as time slipped by, I began to realize there were so many things which were not under my control. And then you learn to depend on God, who actually controls everything. And He is the one who can sustain you. He is the one who can see you through. So I want to really ask you, you know, don't ever think to yourself that you have it all within yourself to do everything. Because you don't control everything. You and I, we don't. We'd like to think we do, but we don't. It's good to remember that. Let me go to the second one. Each one of you, every single one of you, have a distinct calling. I'm fond of saying this. You know, I believe we are all part of a design, and our lives are designed. Every good incident, every difficult and challenging incident goes into that design. And what may seem very, something that you'd like to forget very quickly will actually be something which will help you in a very profound way in the days to come. And then you have that place which you become a person who is flowing into. Every one of us have a distinct calling. You may look at yourself and look at, you know, yourself as a very ordinary person. But then don't forget, God does not look at you that way. You are very special. You are very important to Him. And He has been involved in designing you till now and will continue to work in your life. You know, I often think to myself that right through school and college, I did not get a single medal for academics. The only time I came something to talk about was in my third standard, you know, when I came first in class. Because the guy who came first at that time, he broke his hand. And this guy who came second, he got sick. So I was somewhere around the third rank at that time. And then I slipped down. But when it came to the civil service exams, many years later, and I had to work knowing that studies and academics was not really my strength. Extracurricular activities were. I enjoyed sport. I enjoyed drama. I enjoyed, debating and all of it. And finally, God just made everything into one big package. And I completed 32 years in the Indian Administrative Service, knowing that every small experience blessed me in my positions that I occupied in being a blessing to other people. So this is the second thing I want to leave with you. You are a part of a very intricate design woven by God for the future. And you're going to bless a lot of people. So when you look at yourself and you look at yourself very ordinary, nothing spectacular to talk about, don't forget that you are actually a design in the making by the master designer himself. Let me go to the third one. This is straightforward stuff, you know. I think we must all know that we are accountable for our lives. Nothing is going to come your way just by itself. You are accountable for your time. If there is a nudge in your heart that this is what God wants you to do, or this is what you're going to be placed in, or this is a kind of academic life that you're going to move into after this, then you need to prepare for that. See, if you are a drifter, then you think to yourself that you're not accountable for your life. But you are accountable. All of us have some role to play in pushing God's agenda in our lives by doing what we are supposed to do. So I want to say, take charge of your life. You are accountable. You are accountable. Don't take on any stupid habits which are going to knock the great purposes of God in your life. So I want to say, we are all accountable. Even today at 62, I am accountable for my life. And I have to see it that way. I need to look at it that way. Okay, let me go on to the fourth one. This is a big challenge. I think, we are all in a time we are hearing so many things about the COVID scene. So all of us have got used to sanitizers wherever we go. We go to the malls, we go to any place, you take up a little bit of sanitizer and keep your hands clean. So the fourth point I want to say is this. Keep your hands clean. More importantly, keep your hearts clean. And that's a big challenge. That is a big challenge because no one can see you at the heart level except yourself. You can con a lot of people in your life, but your heart will bear you out. Your heart reveals everything. So keep your hands clean, but better still, keep your heart clean. I know, people who are in their 30s, in their 40s, in their 50s, who have struggled with pornography. They slipped into it when they were in school because it was easy to access. And now, with the internet coming in full force, and you can do so many things and hide your trail, they have got into being obsessed with pornography. Your heart will then weigh you down. And some of these people surface finally with a lot of psychological baggage. And it's a big challenge to them because they are not able to live normally, even in spite of having the best in life. Keep your heart clean. Keep your heart clean. Just know where your money is coming from. Know where your thoughts are coming from. Know where your, if there's any lying spirit in you, know where it's coming from and disregard. Refuse to allow it to take control of your life. Keep your hearts clean. And I want to close with this last one. If you are really smart at any given point in time in your life, just take a step outside of yourself and look at yourself and see what is it that you value the most. What you value the most will show in your behavior. What you value the most will show in what your mind is most occupied with. What do you value the most? If you say, okay, I value money the most, I know if I become a really rich man, I'll be fully done and fully settled in life. Then money will occupy your mind. If you, if sex is obsessing or an obsession to you, you will seek after it and destroy yourself. That will be your values. That's where you are. Your values will need to always be looking at yourself. Sometimes, it could be status. It could be a position. Sometimes it could be property. That's in the core of your value system. I think all of us need to stop. And it can be in your 40s, it can be in your 60s. You look at yourself and say, now, what is my value system all about? And when you look at yourself and check yourself, it gives you an opportunity to stop a bit and correct your lifestyle. I've seen people I know, people who have come across in different walks of life, who have had everything, but the family has been destroyed. But why was it? Because all along they had values which had no place for the family. And then suddenly at one point in time, the family moves on and they are left alone. What are your values? What is your value system? What do you value the most? What do you count as most precious? That is your challenge. To make sure that you actually value something that makes sense to hold on to. I want to leave you with these thoughts, and I want to just say that over the years, I have been really blessed to every now and then retreat to myself, some spend time with God, spend time with myself to evaluate where things are. I'm blessed today with a family. I have what God has blessed me with. Because every step of the way, when the small things came along, I gave it importance. And that's the key. Tomorrow will matter. What you do with your tomorrow will matter. What you do with your day after will matter. And that will keep you going. So I want to just leave you with two verses from the Bible, which I really I've enjoyed reading today. And this is found from Hebrews chapter 13, verse 5 and 6. The second part of Hebrews 13, 5 says, or the whole thing, let me read. Let your conduct be without covetousness. Be content with such things as you have. For he himself has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. And so we boldly say, the Lord is my helper. I will not fear. What can man do to me? I want to leave you with that verse that is read out from Hebrews chapter 13. The Lord Jesus says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. And then a step further, because you say God is your helper, you don't have anything to fear. So may life ahead be a blessing. May you be doubly blessed. And may God grant you all the desires of your heart. Thank you for being with me and listening to me at this time. God bless you all. God bless you all.
Thank you, sir, for sharing with the graduating class your words of wisdom. Thank you for reminding our graduates that they are special, that God is in control and has a plan for their lives, and that he will never leave them nor forsake them. May I now request our principal, Dr. Jerry George Matthew, to speak to the class of 2021, after which he will commend our graduating class to God in prayer.
Good morning to all of you, graduating students, dear parents of our graduating students, dear staff. Good morning to the trustees and the board of management, and good morning to each of our housekeeping and office staff as well. I'm so thankful to be part of this ceremony this morning. So thankful for God's faithfulness in our lives. I'm thankful to God this morning for bringing us to the end of this academic year. You know, we've been surrounded by so much of sickness and sorrow at multiple times through this year. Many of us perhaps would have thought, I don't know if I will survive this year. 25 million people all over the world have lost their lives in just 1 year. That's 10 times the normal number of deaths that happen in any given year. But we survived. We made it. I'm thankful to God for that. We've survived the loss of jobs, the loss of loved ones, sickness, sorrow. We survived the transitions in our way of learning. We learned to shop less, to live with less. We learned to manage our lives within the confines of our homes. We survived the transition from offline to online, from physical textbooks to notebooks and online videos, from pen and paper exams to online MCQs. Our parents, when came back to school, we sat with our children to attend online classes, trying to understand what the teacher is saying and trying to remember what we ourselves studied 30 years ago. We survived. But we have changed. Our world has changed. Our school has changed. We ourselves have changed. Our bodies, our minds, our emotions, our perceptions, we've all changed. You know, many times we are yearning for things to go back to normal. I'm sure you will agree with me. Many times we wake up and say, oh God, how long? Can we just go back to everything becoming normal? You know, can I just go out and meet my friends? Can I just go back to work? Can I, you know, just go back to getting the income that I had? I want things to be normal again. That desire is very normal. But I must tell you that it's unlikely to come true, because we're living in a time that is a new normal. It's brand new. The situation is different. My dear graduating students, how are you going to respond to this change? That change is hard, isn't it? Sudden change is even more horrible. You know, as we grow up, gradually over the years, you have seen changes in your bodies. You've seen changes in your voice, in your mind, in the way your hair grows, and so many things. You've seen so much of different change in your life. And that change is normal, and we learn to accept it. But sudden change like this over a period of 1 year is abnormal, and it's horrible. We don't like it. But it calls for greater resilience, capacity to adapt quickly, and quick perception, discernment in the things that we do. I want to challenge you this morning. The challenge is to become part of the few. Part of the few, not the many. The few who choose a narrow path. The path less trod. You know, because of the education you've received and that you've received here and that you're going to receive, because of the support of family and school and church and friends and community, you know, you're already on a great trajectory to become successful in this world. There is no doubt. You will get good jobs. You will have good families. You will be able to live a comfortable life, accumulate wealth, be happy, live happy, and even die happy. I'm sure about that. But is that all your life is going to be? Is it all that you are going to yearn after? I want to challenge you to be part of the few. You know, that narrow road that I talked about may not bring too much of happiness, riches, power, possession, but it's a higher path. It's a higher path. It's a more honorable path. And it is what God is calling you to. It is what God is calling you to. Narrowed path, part of the few, in terms of, for some of you, it may be the jobs that you pick. You may find these unique niches, you know, that is your interest, and you will become part of those few who get into those spaces, and you will do well and bring a great blessing to the people. The few who choose to go into full-time ministry, I always pray for that. The few who will become, you know, tent makers, who will go into places where there is a community that is struggling, and you will choose to live there and be a blessing to them. I pray for them. But I also pray for those who will take up those issues in our community and who will be passionate about it and make a difference. I pray that our young people will be passionate about issues concerning our world, concerning humanity, and you will make a difference in that. It's my great desire. But for every one of you, boys and girls, I pray that you will choose the narrow path in terms of values, like our chief guest spoke, in terms of priorities, like I told you yesterday, in terms of the purpose of your life, that in terms of the character and values that you emulate, I pray that you will be part of the few, that you will not succumb to corruption, to lies, to deceit, to the false narrative that is happening in our world, that you will choose to live in the narrow path. That's the best place to be. That's the place God wants you to be. I want to challenge you with that. I want to say thank you to our staff for the wonderful work that they have done. I want to thank you for adjusting so quickly to the new normal, for allowing us to come into your homes. The entire school, our students, our parents were able to come there and learn from you. truly a Gurukul system, isn't it? Sitting in the home of the teacher and learning. I want to thank you for adjusting with the salary cuts that we had. I want to thank you for your faith, for continuing in the school. I want to thank the Board of Management and trustees for your faith in us and for supervising and overseeing for the good of the school. I want to thank our students for your good heart. And I wish you much blessing as you step out of the portals of the school. We are praying daily for you that you will succeed in your board exams, do well for the glory of God, and then move on into a new life. Let me end with a poem called The Few by an unknown poet. I want to share my screen for that. This is the poem, The Few. The easy roads are crowded and the level roads are jammed. The pleasant little rivers with the drifting folks are cramped. But off yonder, where it's rocky, where you get a better view, you will find the ranks are thinning and the travelers are few. Where the going's smooth and pleasant, you will always find the throng. For the many, most the pity, seem to like to drift along. But the steps that call for courage and the task that's hard to do, in the end, results in glory for the never wavering few. God bless you, boys and girls. Let's pray together. Our gracious God and loving Heavenly Father, this morning we thank you for your faithfulness in our lives and in the life of Clarence High School this past 1 year. We can recount so many ways that you have been gracious to us, so many things we were able to do, we were able to adapt to the new normal. We thank you for keeping our teachers and students and office staff safe. We thank you, Lord, for every parent, and thank you for your goodness in their lives. Even though we went through sorrow and sickness, even though we went through pain and trouble, Lord, you have not changed. You have remained faithful. You have given us the grace to hold on. And now we commend our graduating class of 2021. Every boy and girl whose head is bowed this morning, we seek your faithfulness and grace in their lives. Thank you, Lord, for sustaining them through this stressful time. And I pray and ask that, Lord, you would just uphold them, strengthen them by your grace, enable them as they prepare for the model exams next week, and then the final exams, the board exams in May and June. We pray, Lord, that you would bless them, grant them success in all that they do. And I pray that every one of them would move on with good memories from Clarence School. I pray that they would go into good colleges and schools. I pray that you provide for their needs financially, emotionally, spiritually, and physically. And I pray that you would strengthen them to know your will and to do it, O God, that they may know you in a personal way, that they may know your love, that they may seek to pray to you daily and to read your word and to understand it and apply it in their lives. As we said this morning, Lord, we pray that they would take the less trodden path, that they would have the courage to make wise decisions in their lives. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for sustaining them. Bless them, Lord, we pray. In the precious name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Principal Sir. May I request you all to kindly stand to attention wherever you are for the school song.
Loving gracious hand hath given us a playing field and school and
we have come to the end of another memorable Thanksgiving and valedictory service. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for being a part of our celebration. Dear graduating class of 2021, you have shown that no challenge is insurmountable. No dream or goal is unattainable. Celebrate what you have accomplished. Apply the best of what you have learned in your head and felt in your heart. We will all be rooting for you to take the narrow path, the less trodden path, and become leaders who will make a difference in the world. May I request all the families and friends out there in cyberspace to give a loud round of applause to the graduate in your family. And now may I ask the graduates to give a hand to the family and teachers and mentors who have supported you. Thank you. Congratulations, class of 2021. Thank you, one and all. Have a blessed weekend.